Hi, good morning to all my Facebook friends. This is Gary Gan here, live from beautiful sunny Sunday Malaysia. How are you? I hope you are having a good time. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, good night to you wherever you are in this world. All right. So today, just finished an amazing morning walk with my beautiful children. As usual, forest in the city, breathing in amazing fresh air. The day is just awakened with such positivity and inspiration. So much hope of what's going to happen in the coming days. It's so amazing to my Chinese friends. Chinese New Year is just around the corner, so there's a lot of festive season. I know there's a lot of anxiety, there's a lot of negative moods out there due to the COVID, due to the pandemic. But then again, life is like this. There's a lot of ups and downs, right? Sunshine, rain, thunderstorms, flooding, rainbows. So hope you, today's message is getting you in the right frame. But anyway, I hope what I'm going to share today is going to give you a different perspective of your life, of how you probably, if you are a parent, how you probably is going to have a different way of bringing up your children. Okay, first and foremost, I'd like to say a big thank you to a very good friend of mine as well as my business partner in my Enagic business, Mr. Sam Sia. So Sam, I hope you are watching this video. I'm making this video to thank you for that message that you have sent to me early this morning while I was walking with my kids. And that message really just opened another perspective of what I want to share with y'all today and what I am actually doing with my own personal life and how I'm actually bringing up my children. It may serve as a guide to you. It may give you a different perspective of life and what's happening in the world today. All right, so today's title is basically, I got a message from Sam, and the message is, the law of diminishing, the law of wasting efforts. So what is that law all about? So basically that WhatsApp message is about, despite animals, let's say a lion goes out hunting, lions are not in the zoo, right? The lions in the zoo do not need to hunt. They are just fed, just like employees. Now that's another topic. I will talk to you another day, all right? But the lions in the wild, the lions in the safari, the lions in the wilderness of Africa, in India, or probably in Malaysia. Now these lions, they go out hunting every morning, afternoon or night. I don't know when they hunt. I'm not a zoologist, I'm not a wildlife expert, but when they hunt is when they're hungry. So they're hungry, they hunt. But you and I know that every attempt the lion goes out to hunt, it's not 100% success. In fact, that message that Sam sent to me says that on an average, 75% of the lion, of the attempt the lion made for hunting, does not work out. That means 75%, that means out of every 100 times the lion goes out to catch his prey for breakfast, lunch or dinner, whatever it is, and he's so hungry, 75 out of the 100 times, it doesn't catch us anything. It's what today's society called a failure. Can you imagine? He don't catch, he goes out, he works so hard, he knows all the knowledge, he knows all the skill, he tried it, and he didn't get anything. 75 times out of 100 times, nothing. Only 25%, 25 times out of the 100 times, it catches something. But I want to ask you this very simple question. Do you think the lion gets to eat every single day? And you and I know, the lions eat every single day. The tiger eats every single day. The cheetah, the leopard, whatever it is that catches prey, they eat every time. So what is the difference here? The difference here is the lion or any other prey out there, the predator, the animals in the wild, they know very well that if they go out and put in consistent action, they will get the results they want. And it's okay not to get the results initially. It's okay if they have 75 losses, 75 what we call in the human world as failure. That's the reason why I don't like to use the word failure. It's not about failure, it's not about failing. It gives a very negative connotation to life. It's about trying and not getting what you want. That is not failure. When you try and you don't get it, it could be because of a few reasons. Either you are not fast enough, your strategy is wrong, it was the wrong timing. But it has nothing to do with you. Your role is to act. The lion knows it, the cheetah knows it, the tiger knows it. And therefore, they never go out and try to catch a prey, and then after 10 attempts, imagine 10 times he's trying to catch, and then he sits there and says, I think this catching prey thing is rubbish, you know. I think it's not for me. Maybe I'm not a lion, you know. Maybe I'm just a hyena, or I'm just a domesticated dog, a pet, a cat. No, the lion never thinks like that. The lion knows that as long as he goes out to hunt, he will get the result. He will get the prey. He will get breakfast, lunch, and dinner. But the point is, they accept the fact that there are times when they don't get it. So now, the biggest question is, why when animals can think like that and humans don't? And I replied that same text message back to Sam in my own knowledge, through my own journey, through my own experience, and this is what I told Sam. So then, Sam, am I right? This is what I told you, right? If you are watching this, give me a comment, okay? I told Sam, I said, the biggest difference between animals and human beings is animals are not programmed. And that's the reason why I am so, I got so funny. It's a joke, okay? It's actually a joke, but this joke is really, really deep, okay? And it is really very meaningful. I saw a Facebook post and somebody put that, it's like a comic kind of joke, you know? It says, the Amish, do you know why the Amish community do not have? You know the Amish community, right? They don't have electricity, they don't even use telephone, they don't watch TV. They are small minority groups in US called the Amish. They say, why don't the Amish community have COVID-19? And you know why? What's the answer? It says that because they do not have television. Now guys, the reason why people are so different from animals, even with so high intellectual capacity, so high brain cells, so high brain power, and we are able to think, we have created rocket that can go to the moon, to the Mars, we have cars, we have made our life so comfortable, and we are so superior. A lot of people think we are so superior compared to the animals, right, in the jungle, right? The only reason why humans are so and accept the fact that if they don't get something, if they try, they don't get something, it's a failure and they give up, they stop trying, is because of this thing called programming. Guys, we are a product of mass programming. And you and I know, you can see, when a baby is being born and is trying to walk, that programming was still okay. And that's the reason why there is no people, unless they have some health issue, birth defects, and they can't walk, that's another story. But majority of babies that are born are walking today as teenagers and adults, because at that level, the programming was still good. What's the programming? You know, the baby tried to walk, fall down. The parent never said, oh, you fall down so many times. Don't try anymore. It's hurting you. Let me carry you. Can you imagine if the parent do that, what's going to happen to that baby? For the rest of his human life experience, this person will not be able to walk. Am I right? But because the parents encourage the baby to keep trying, the key is trying, in spite of the falls, in spite of the failure, in spite of the challenges, every children or everybody is walking today is normal, right? But the moment that child goes to bigger, okay, goes to school, you see how society is punishing people for mistakes. And that's basically programming. You go and sit for exam, the those who score the aces, the full A's, the full marks are being rewarded, like celebrated as a celebrity. And those who are failing, those who are somehow either they try or they didn't try, whatever it is, so-called failure, are being punished for being failure. But why isn't any parent actually even celebrating the act of acting? At least they try to act. And that's the same message I told Sam. I said, I'm not here to say that I'm a perfect parent or I'm a perfect father or amazing something. I'm not saying that, but this is what I do for my children. Okay, this is what I do. I let them do it. In other words, I let them take the responsibility of acting. I let them take the action. Even if they fail, I will reward them, I will celebrate them. I'm not rewarding them for that failure. I'm rewarding them for the courage to act. That is very important, guys. It's not about the outcome. The outcome can be good, just like the lion. He goes out to hunt 75 times, it doesn't catch anything, but that 25 times that he caught is enough to fill the belly of the lion for its entire life, because he knows very well that 75% will somehow go away, the 25% he will get his breakfast, lunch and dinner. So the point I'm trying to say is celebrate the act, the courage to act, rather than punish the results of failing. I mean, of course, if you sit an exam and you don't get the results you want, have you ever asked that question, why a person sat an exam and never got the results that they want? Think about this. It could be that person never studied, but if you dwell it deeper, why isn't the person studying? Why doesn't the person have that joy of wanting to learn something? Could it be that person, or is it because the education industry is screwed up? Or could it be the information is already outdated? Could it be the information has been delivered, the information that has been delivered is really out of the context? I mean, I'm not here again to put any parties down or to condemn anything, but my son was having an online class in our living room the other day. And the way I saw the teacher deliver the online message, I told myself, if I were my son's age, I would also fall asleep on the computer. I mean, again, it's all about mass society's programming. Now, if you are under this wrong programming, you may end up in the wrong world. You may end up in the wrong results. And today, a lot of people, if you can see, the majority of people are suffering, depressed, not getting what they want, regrets, not living to their full potential. Why? Because of this wrong programming. So guys, the difference between humans with such powerful intellect compared to animals with literally basic instinct, the difference is in the programming. So guys, seriously, for your sake, for your life, for your family's life, think of what's the programming that's happening in your life and your children's life. If you are a parent, ask yourself this question. What kind of programming your children is getting? Sometimes, I have to say this, I'm also guilty for acting like this. Sometimes, the very loved ones of that child, especially the parent, are also creating that wrong programming. And I don't blame you, I don't blame myself, because we are also being programmed by programmers who have been programmed. So life is like this. So if you want to break the chain of programming, you need to really look out in the world, start sit down, instead of keep doing certain things, just look at how your life is going, how your life is progressing, and if it's not going the way you want, we can always change, right? We are human beings, we can always change. We are not the trees, you know, trees cannot change. But we are human beings, we can always, always change. Okay, so I hope this message really, really impact you or open a light bulb in your head in a way or the other that can really, really change your life and probably change somebody's lives out there. Alright, so guys, once again, I wish you an amazing weekend. Gary Gunn here once again, live from beautiful sunny Malaysia. And as usual, drop me a comment there. If you find today's topic is very relevant, If you have some similar incident or you have something that's related to this topic, please give me some comment there so that I know we are somehow connected. And whether you agree on this, you don't agree, just give me your point of view, alright? And as usual, if you think this message is very powerful and it's helping you, it may help somebody out there. So I strongly recommend you to click that share button so that this message can find itself all over the world and probably save and change someone's life. So here with this, Gary Gan here once again, wish you the very best. God bless you. And as usual, let's be the miracle the world is waiting for. And with this, have a great day. Bye.